car behind you, pull right over. Actually, probably right up here. It's just to take a quick look and make sure that it's not zoomed in. I got a fart.
Horrible. Ah!
Honey, the camera's on. What about all the farts you were cutting last night?
Jesus.
They were terrible.
I don't care if the camera's on. It stinks.
Straight down.
No, I can see the car in front of us.
Yeah, you got to sort of be on an angle.
Yeah, so, I can see the car in front of us.
All right, and you can see it both sides of the highway?
Yeah.
You can?
Yep. Right. You can see more of that side than this side. But you can see both sides. I can see the trees and stuff.
Right, yeah. But you're sort of on
an angle, yeah.
All right.
What do you want to make on this? It's going to cost us $4.
Triple M. off or anything, right?
Nope.
There's air actually coming out of this frame, but it's not glass because it's the part of the defroster, so I can't cover it up. All right, it's part of the defroster, so it's not going to cover it up. right off the Thruway.
Fairfield and Thruway.
Yeah, she says you could actually see it right off the Thruway.
So. Smart, I exit 27. Get off at 33.
Yeah, but look how many miles there are between exits on this thing. Plus, they have too many. They have the A's and the C's where they put exits in between. Right? Yeah, remember. It's not.
It just seems like, you know, wow, we're going to be there in no time.
Well, it's not going to be 4 hours. Yeah. Not unless we get bad weather or something happens. Rural New York was like, as a kid, it seemed like it was forever.
Slide. I used to hate
That would be a little bit scary.
Yeah. Whenever it snowed, I always just leave the work early.
Pictures is what I think you can take with that. The book's with it. It's in that camera case. No, I don't think so. I think the book is too big for that. But it looks like when it starts up, it says 21. So it's 21 pictures. So I don't know where 16 came from.
21 shots.
41 shots.
I think it's 41.
Now, no garb, right? No garb?
No garb. Just my knee highs.
Believe me. Go in the bathroom and go with those.
Yeah.
Leave me out of it. There's a motel for you. You see it?
What?
Burning Dunes.
I'm waiting to see the Travel Lodge. I just seen Econo Lodge.
Did you see the TA on there?
No. Is that the Tits and Ass Hotel?
It must be. It said T/A. I'm thinking to myself, well, that must be a winner. I never even thought about Tits and Ass.
Leave it to me. I know.
To you. I'm sure that's exactly where you would have won.
About 72
before, so that's that's the correct color for it. That's why the sheriffs are changing.
Yeah.
It's a hard color of nose. And the way they do the lights now, you don't even see them. They're like ski wraps.
These guys over there. Trump's gonna pass.
So no, like, there's not a big hill for me to get a jump on.
Yeah.
If I get a hill, then I can lose
it. Yeah, right.
I can't lose it without a hill. Goddamn engine that thing's buried this car. I might have to stop at that.
Service area?
Service area. You?
I feel fine right now.
So it's 44 miles, so we had a ways to go. It's like probably right before we did. Dragons.
Yeah.
Because she doesn't like them.
Yeah.
That's what she said.
To that one.
Girl. And I believe she probably would have. But.
I like her.
I like her too, but that's not a good thing to say.
No.
But if she's Filipino, she's most likely Catholic. And it's Catholic religion. Catholic abortion is a no-no.
Yeah.
Filipinos, the majority of them are Catholics.
Are they?
So, she's letting the religion get in the way of her.
Yeah.
But, you're going to say, she's been doing it for so many years, and you know, that's where the doctors think, that's where the doctors go.
Yeah.
You know, the
doctors' wives. Are they ducks?
Yep.
Wow. I thought they fly south. Ducks don't.
No. Those are geese.
Oh.
They're all hanging out there. Right next to you and under you. I mean, come on.
Yeah.
Oh, there's that place that my grandfather had gotten went to.
Oh, the one that says
Three Fish right below, yeah. Yep. Shoot. You have to get up. Right, have to. Yeah, that's it. I took a picture of the pond. You were with me that day.
Yeah.
But I never got a picture of the place across the road. That's where you used to go over it. Because you used another, you'd always have coffee.
Yeah.
Between it. I asked my Uncle Dave, drinks decaffeinated. He's in real bad shape the last time I saw him.
Oh, really?
But he was down at the garage, yeah. He had some party, had strokes. I don't hear nothing. But anyway, because my Aunt Bonnie's the same way as my mother.
Yeah.
But at any rate, between him and my grandfather Hickok, the coffee industry was much richer. My Uncle Dave, he is the originator of drinking cold coffee. He drank coffee, didn't matter if it sat in the pot for days and it was cold, ice cold, he drank it. Now, I never knew anyone. Cold coffee now is like a normal thing. They sell it. But yeah, he was the only one I ever knew that drank cold coffee.
Because
he just drank coffee, right?
Wow.
Years ago, 30 years ago, before it was even existed anywhere.
See, you could have been a millionaire.
And it's just, he just drank so much fucking coffee, it's unbelievable. Right, he could have invented it.
Yeah, nice coffee.
But, the last time I saw him, he was at the garage, and he said, I remember what he said he heard, song did he say you heard that reminded me? You see, as soon as I heard it, it reminded me of you and your hippie days. What the fuck song was it? American Pie.
Oh, really?
Yeah, that's what he said. As soon as I walked in, he says, "Hey, Jimmy." And he says, "Oh, hey, I'm Dave. How's it going?" So he says, "You know, the other day I heard American Pie on the radio, and I immediately thought of you and your hippie days." I says, you know, I've never been associated with American Pie and hippie days.
Yeah, really?
That's a compliment. He says, it is. When you had your real long hair and all that, he says, so you were the first person I thought of when I heard that song.
Yeah, geez, you don't even know how Aunt Bonnie's doing either.
And we stopped by their place at one time and they weren't.
Yeah.
They weren't living there?
Yeah.
Well, I didn't realize where they were living across the street at his brother's place, in that place that looked just like an old building, but in the back it was gorgeous.
Yeah.
Well, I guess they were staying there.
Oh.
When I ran into Sparky. But then they were buying a house, or Sparky was buying a house or something. My Uncle Dave was living there with him.
Oh.
Well, was staying with him anyway. Because he was in real bad shape. So he actually lost fingers and stuff from diabetes.
Really?
Yeah. He had been quite a few years.
Yes.
But he got a Social Security disability. It took him a long time. Yeah. But nowhere else but me. He ended up getting SSI.
Yeah. Oh, really?
Yeah. He ended up getting SSI because he didn't have enough credits for Social Security. Because he just didn't work consistently. It took him a long time to get SSI. And with SSI, you don't get back pay or anything. You keep fighting them. And when you get it,
you start
at that point. Right. Because you didn't pay into it. So therefore, there's no reason for them to give it to you.
Yeah. Well, that makes sense.
So, I know it took him a long time to get it. But I got it for his medical.
Yeah.
But he just simply didn't hold a job down long enough and work consistently enough to get it. See, that's what helped me out was the fact that I was consistent. My income went up, and so did my payment to Social Security, which raised my... I'm only getting $100 less than you a month.
Right.
But yet you worked...
Was it 24?
well, you worked at least 10 to 15 years longer than I did.
Yeah, I just didn't get the pay.
Right, but because of me excelling and making more money, it enabled me to get, and plus, not to mention the fact that technically I've been on Social Security longer than you have.
Right.
Because I went as in 1997 on record. You didn't go on until 2000.
Yeah.
So I've been on Social Security 3 years longer than you. And Medicare 3 years longer. Well, fucking do something. Sandwich me between these two fucking trucks, asshole. Jesus Christ. C-Dub. That's what his plate says.
Yeah.
C-Dub, yes. It's the worst, really a comfortable place to be between two tractor trailer trucks.
I don't think you want to pass the other one. He's after us, honey.
I know, it's a dual. I recognize the guy driving. Looks like Harris.
Yeah. I could just see Harris driving the truck like that.
Somebody's blinking their lights. The tractor trailer truck just blinked his lights. Oh, I know what you did that for.
What?
Let him know it was clear to get back over.
Oh. Is it 5 miles to the rest area?
Yep.
Service area.
Iroquois service area. So that's probably part of Iroquois. Thruway does go through Indian reservation lands.
Does it?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, 5 miles I'm going to have to.
Okay.
What about you?
All
right. We aren't really actually that far from where we got to go, and it's certainly right off the thruway, so. And I don't mind hanging out for the rest of the day there, because we only got.
Well, we can't check in until 3 o'clock.
Right. But I'm saying, we're not going to get there much before 3.
Yeah.
Anyway. It's going to get dark at 4:30.
Yeah, right.
So the thing we got to do is make sure we set the alarm in the morning.
Right.
To get up early enough so we can get going. And I got to find out through the hotel place about a Chamber of Commerce. Now the one courtyard had one right there in the building. Now I doubt this is going to. Well, we'll get there time enough to check in. They let us check in 3 hours early.
Yeah, that other time, yeah.
Since the room was already ready.
I never realized they had check-in times.
Well, they would have to.
Yeah.
Check-out times. Check-out times are at noon time. Check-in is at 3. So the guy can go at least 3 hours so people can get in and clean the rooms and stuff. Otherwise, you wouldn't have any time to clean the rooms.
Yeah.
Right. Did you fart?
No.
It wasn't me.
I didn't say anything.
Huh?
I didn't say anything.
You didn't have to. You're not looking at me. Why?
Because. Change from those.
Yeah, he's did you hear me? She got him at Woodstock when she was on something. Did you hear me say that?
No.
Oh, you didn't?
No.
You cracked up. I says, yeah. He says, well, we saw those right here. I says, that's where she really got them.
Yeah.
But she was just getting back from Woodstock. He had your friend, your lens, he knew you got it.
Yeah.
Because he had everything right on the computer.
Yeah, because he said, probably not.
But you said you didn't need it.
No.
You said everything was fine.
Yep, everything's fine.
Because I had written down on my notes, I was in. Don't need one.
I don't feel so many, right?
Well, when you get down, you should get one every so many years.
Well, I'll get one the next year.
Right. You don't necessarily I don't know about that guy. He's like, I have an eye exam person do it, and then they sell glasses. It's like they're going to make you buy glasses is all they're really
doing. Oh, you mean the Dr. Gunn?
I don't know why you can't get an eye exam done by the primary care physician.
Yeah.
Because they're not there to sell glasses.
Oh, and that one I went to, that woman?
Oh, yeah, she was there. But I think we should have it done independently.
Well, we can do that.
Because when I went, it was like he did all these things, and then this other woman did some things and checked everything out, and I was fine. He says, okay, well, now it's time to go out and get glasses.
Yeah.
You know, it was like...
Yeah. Well, see, the optometrist does more, too, because they do that thing where they dilate your eyes.
They don't do that anymore, he said.
Oh, they don't do it anymore?
No. They use the machine on you. They said they've done away. They don't do that anymore. Got this new
thing. Oh.
They got this new thing now that you look into.
Oh.
And that's what they took the place of doing your eyes like
oh,
that.
Oh, that's good. Because boy, that killed you when you went outside.
Right. You don't have to do that anymore.
That's good.
Not, or at least not at Walmart.
Oh, I'm sure they wouldn't
have optometrists too. Alright. Are you gonna be alright right here?
Make it snappy.
Yep.
Shut the door before it blows in. Too late, it already did.
Huh?
It already did.
Give me
huh?
Give me my cup. It's got coffee in it, be careful.
Yeah, mine's got a little in it too, but it's cold.
Okay, let me have that.
So cute. Yeah, you cutie.
They had shot glasses in there, but nothing at just New York.
There was a SUV pulled in here, and there was an old lady, and she had one of those little Yorkies.
Oh, yeah?
With the black and then, like, the blondish face,
uh-huh.
About the size of the one in the doctor's office.
Yeah.
So I just smiled over here, and she puts the dog up so I could see his dog. So cute. Right, sitting there, right on her lap.
Probably all the way down the highway.
Yep.
No, there it goes the whole time. Yeah, that's fine. Nice New York shot glasses in there, had like the skyline of New York City.
Oh, really?
Yeah, but we already had a New York shot glass.
Yeah.
I was like, for one, it might have set a risk in the on it or something. That's right. We'll get to that area. Ask for the room. That's for this one. I got a good inspection sticker then. I got mine. I don't have to take mine.
I know what happened one year.
I thought it was a registration because the registration one never stuck.
Well, see, they must have official plates, so maybe they don't have. Maybe it's different.
But she had her inspection sticker stuck on there. But New Hampshire had the same problem.
Yeah.
She was saying there that night, that girl saying that they had a blue problem with their
stickers. That's right. That's right. That happened one year when I was still working there, and it was a while that you could tape it on.
Verified your ID number and all that, but he just had to get approval for the glasses.
Oh.
So that's what he was waiting for.
Thank you. one of Denny's plenty of times smashed.
Oh. And we're down to Schenectady. I went to once. All right. So there's one time earlier. Ted was working for Bob Alex. In fact, he had his truck. He had the license. And he stopped over at Bob Alex's truck. He was on call.
Mr. Cool.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And I says, well, and he says, I've been hankering for a good banana split. So he must have drove all over the city of Schenectady. Trying to find a banana split. We ended up at Denny's.
They had banana splits?
They had banana splits.
Wow.
And of course he's on call. So what's he do? He shuts the cell phone off. That's the same truck. He hands his son the keys.
Oh, yeah.
You know. So his son takes the keys and leave. So that's bullshit. I hear the truck start up, take off. A little while later, I says, well, where'd your son go? He says, he didn't go anywhere. I says, your truck left a long time ago. He says, what? I says, your truck left a long time ago. He drove off on it. He didn't. He looks up. Oh, my God. I says, you told him to. But he knows I was only joking.
Apparently
so,
not.
I says, let's go find it. So he hops into it. I had my Cavalier wagon. We're driving all around the city trying to find the son, Joe, with the fucking truck. Bob Alex's four-wheel drive truck, and his son's only like 15 years old, just got out of juvenile detention.
Oh my God.
He says, what the fuck you handing the keys for? I didn't know he was gonna really go do it. I said, well, I heard it start off and take off. I thought it was fucking. You told him to take it. So anyway, I forget where. Oh, he ended up back at the parked out front again. By the time we drove all over trying to find the truck, we went back to the house, and the truck was parked there, and he was sitting there. He says, I don't know why you're going to get on his ass. You know, it's not like, you know, he just got out of juvenile detention.
Yeah.
Ted hadn't seen the kid. The kid's like 15 years old. Ted hadn't seen the kid in 11 years or something. The kid spent all his time in juvenile detention homes and foster homes. And,
that's too bad.
You know? Even, you know, didn't even know his mother.
Oh, really?
And so, and here's a guy telling me that I missed.
Out on
how I missed part of life by not having a family, by having kids. Him and,
Tim, was it?
Tim, or maybe it was Tim and Joe. I don't know, it was one of the three, there was two of the three of them. It's like, you've got to be kidding. And then I like nailed them with each one of them. Also, I actually really missed paying all that money in child support that you went to jail for.
Yeah, right.
And how much have you seen your kids, Tim?
Yeah.
This is what I'm missing? This is, you guys got to be too fucked up.
That's a grim dairy. Milk.
Yeah, but don't taste like that. You know that yourself.
Yeah, I said used to.
Coming in a hurry with this stuff, so we're picking up a little traffic. We're out to our guts. Well, Herkimer County. What is it?
41 miles for the next rest stop.
That's hail. That's ice. It sure is.
It's not ready.
That's ice. That is. It sounds like hail stones hit the window. on it.
Yeah.
I can see it. It says 38 degrees, but it's actually getting warmer. The temperature's going up out this way. Centrally located, so it doesn't look like too far away from Oneida, Oneida Castle, and those areas that you can get to. So get up before the sun tomorrow. Get ready. Get out during sunrise. I'll see what I can find out tonight from where we're at. You might have a phone book that might list a story.
Yeah.
Or they might have that information right there. Jesus Christ, I'm not a half a tank on it. Should have gas. I think it's full.
Wrong, next three axes.
33 is also considered wrong, unless they got A, B, and like 31A and stuff like that. 12 miles was the exit we got off of last time.
Walk river.
Oh, there we go.
Does it?
Yeah. It must be towards the end of the Mohawk River there. There's a little bit bigger than a street.
That wasn't the Mohawk River you're talking about, that Indian.
No, no, no. We got to cross on until Oneida to cross that river. I think that's the Mohawk River. That's part of the Mohawk River. Except for we're hitting up towards the end of the river.
Oh.
Unless it forks off somewhere. Because the Erie Canal was bigger than the river. And actually, the Erie Canal ran alongside the river. The whole length of the river. So it went from Buffalo to... Buffalo through St. Anthony. That part of your, that Erie Boulevard used to be the Erie Canal.
Yeah.
What a money making deal that was. They could have had all kinds of businesses. Yeah, years ago. Well, you know what the problem was, is that it's going through the history books doing the family research. Right there at that large intersection of State and Erie Boulevard. Crossover before you head down to 890.
Uh-huh.
Well, there used to be a bridge. And all along the Mohawk, a lot of trunks were falling in and drowning. And they were having a big problem. The death rate was really high. Just rhinos and hobos just drowning. Because that was a big railroad town. And of course, where the railroad was, you had a lot of rhinos and hobos.
Right.
And there were just a lot of, and it was being used as a dump. Dumping sewage in there, garbage, wagon wheels, tires, and it became so polluted that they just decided to fill it in. And General Electric was getting big enough to where they needed more highway space. But they said the stench of the Erie Canal was so bad that people couldn't even, they didn't want to go downtown. So there was multiple reasons for doing what they did, including the fact that GE was growing and it needed it. So cars were also becoming more popular. And so therefore, they decided to switch it over. But some of those buildings, including that building I pointed out to you, that the EWI school was in, the one right. Theater front, that building was actually there originally when it was the Erie Canal.
Oh, really?
The building that says the Bangkok restaurant.
Yep.
It's like that building also was there when it was the Erie Canal.
Uh-huh.
So was the building that the second school I went to. That building was also there at the time the Erie Canal was there. The only thing that's missing was this side where they're all new buildings, where flat. Stuff and the Amtrak station sitting there. Well, that right there is, there were a bunch of buildings there that are no longer there. But the other three corners, the buildings that run alongside them, a lot of them are original buildings that were there when it was actually the Erie Canal. Truck passing me. all these trucks within 10 miles.
Yeah.
Huh?
Yeah.
Stop on the phone too. Mayflower. That's the name of our insurance company, our life insurance company.
Mayflower.
Well, actually, it was Mayflower that changed. In fact, we used Mayflower. In fact, I think that was the one company when our stuff was stolen.
Oh, really?
Military paid for moving companies. The Japanese were incredible. They wrapped every single thing as if it was a gift when they backed.
This is
unbelievable.
I know, and you said, didn't you say you were saying you went to bring a present to your house?
Yes, that was the thing. But when you went shopping there,
yeah,
they didn't use bags. They wrapped everything. Everything you bought in all the department stores were wrapped. Nothing went in the bag. So now, I'm sure that's all changed now.
Yeah.
But back then,
yeah,
that's the way they did it.
Wow.
Yeah. And they were fast. They were very fast.
Huh.
And it wasn't because you wanted some gift wrap. That's just the way
that's
they
the way it was.
You checked out. And they wrapped it.
Wow.
When you went to the department stores.
1 mile.
So, Oneida also would be the same exit from this.
Yep.
Direction. Turning Stone Casino.
Hey, drop me off at the casino.
You ain't going there.
I know.
You can't order a lot of tickets. That big building?
Yeah, I think so.
You gotta be kidding.
Oh, it looks like a big building in the picture.
Does it?
Yeah. Oh, maybe not that.
Not that one.
Not that one.
Oh. My change. What's $4 a month?
10 cents.
It's gotta be a dime. Turning Stone Casino. That's got to be the turning.
That's part of his Turning Stone, yeah.
He said something about taking a left. How you doing? There's four. There's 10 cents. Right? Doesn't look like he would have been too much into telling you how to get anywhere.
$3.65.
All services. Verona, insane to go this way. All right, well, what road are we supposed to be on to get to the
365. Oh no, that's where it was changed on the
quality in.
Oh, 9 miles.
Verona, 4. You gotta go to Verona. Right?
Yeah.
Verona helps.
That's Vernon. That's not.